ओके एटा एक्सेप्ट करो एटा कंटिन्यू करो ओके कंटिन्यू करो सो ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स फ्रॉम द वाइटल फोर्स थ्योरी द फर्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट वाज दैट ऑर्गन कैन ओनली सिंथेसाइज द ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स बट आफ्टर होलर इन लेबोरेटरी फ्रॉम द अमोनियम साइनेट आफ्टर द रिएक्शन वी गॉट यूरिया which is organic compound okay it shows organic compounds that's mean actually now carbon containing compounds it shows catenation ability of carbon atoms to combine forming long chain okay catenation property what is the catenation property that's mean carbon can form carbon carbon chain okay like this carbon carbon chain like this so many chain may form by carbon okay so this property is known as catenation property of carbon or any element which can form a chain amongst themselves is known as catenation property but for carbon the catenation property is highest okay so carbon it contains catenation ability of carbon atoms to combine forming long chain it is known as catenation property so organic chemistry it is the carbon chemistry only okay so introduction what are the organic compounds what is the organic compound compounds which contain carbon eta amra bar bar bolchi okay so this is the methane glucose ethanol this is methane this is glucose this is ethanol okay this is carbon dioxide but carbon dioxide is not organic compound carbon monoxide is not organic compound sodium carbonate is not organic compound okay sodium bicarbonate is also not organic compound ammonium cyanate it is not organic compound okay so sodium chloride HCl H2SO4 sodium hydroxide okay they are not organic compound clear so compound which contain carbon but carbon dioxide carbon monoxide contains carbon but it is not organic compound why so which one is the organic and which one is inorganic organic compounds this is organic but this is not organic compound this is inorganic compound because it contains ions sodium carbon monoxide is not organic though it contains carbon okay now but what is this carbon monoxide carbon dioxide metal carbonates and bicarbonate cyanates are inorganic compounds though they contain carbon because these compounds do not follow the properties of organic compound what happened here carbon monoxide carbon dioxide bicarbonates cyanates inorganic compounds though they contains carbon but they do not follow the properties of organic compounds is it okay so the correct classification of the organic compounds will be this okay so this is organic and this is inorganic compound is it okay though this compound has carbon now organic compounds inorganic compounds organic compound extracted from the living organism that is sugar urea etc okay this is urea fertilizer okay this is sugar chini jeta ke bole amra inorganic study of non living organisms such as rocks minerals etc eglo sob inorganic eglo boite tumra pabe you will get in your books but just I am remembering it okay In 1815, Berzelius proposed that vital force was responsible for the formation of organic compounds. Who responsible for this? Berzelius. And in 1828, Wohler, who discovered urea from the ammonium cyanate. We already discussed about it. So ammonium cyanate, this is inorganic compound. From the inorganic compound, after rearrangement. in heating we'll get urea. Okay, this is organic compound. So in laboratory, the first compound of organic compound synthesis in laboratory is urea. Is it okay? So you should remember this. So vital force theory was disproved by this Bohler. Okay, so vital force theory was discarded. And what was the vital force theory? Vital force theory was that organic compounds only will be synthesized in living organism. So that was discarded. Okay, now in 1845, Kolbe, that was the man, synthesized acetic acid from its elements. So this is the second compound. Kolbe synthesized acetic acid from its element in laboratory. Okay, so this was the second compound. And 1856, Bartholet synthesized methane in laboratory. So only 100 years after 100 years we have now crore and crore organic compound synthesized in laboratory. Okay, so at first they are not preparing organic compound because they know it was not possible to synthesize organic compound in laboratory. Okay, অর্থাৎ আমরা কখনোই বিশ্বাস করিনি যে অর্গানিক কম্পাউন্ড ল্যাবরেটরিতে তৈরি করা সম্ভব। সমর্পিতা বুঝলে? সমর্পিতা ঢুকেছে তো?
হ্যাঁ স্যার।
অগ্নি, অনিক, অর্পণ, চন্দ্রাণী, চন্দ্রিমা, তাহলে বুঝতে পারছো যে আমরা কেন এই অর্গানিক 100 বছরে মধ্যে আমরা ক্রোর এন্ড ক্রোর কম্পাউন্ড তৈরি করতে পেরেছি, তার আগে কেন অর্গানিক কম্পাউন্ড তৈরি হয়নি? তার কারণ আগে লোকের বিশ্বাসই ছিল যে অর্গানিক কম্পাউন্ড আমরা ল্যাবরেটরিতে তৈরি করতে পারবো না, একমাত্র অর্গানিক অর্গান তৈরি করতে পারবে, এটাই লোকের বিশ্বাস ছিল। কিন্তু আফটার ডিসকভারিং অফ ইউরিয়া নাও দিস ভ্যানিশ। ওকে, so we discard the vital force. Now we are able to synthesize organic compound in laboratory. Okay, so organic compounds are extracted from which one is the correct living organism. That was the first answer. Okay, organic compounds are extracted from living organism. That was the answer. Now, first synthesized organic compound urea was obtained from ammonium cyanide or ammonium cyanate or ammonium nitrate or ammonium nitrite or all of these. Which one is correct? Chandima, bolo, which one is the correct? First synthesized organic compound urea was obtained from, which option is correct?
Sir, ammonium cyanate.
Ammonium cyanate, yes, not cyanide. Okay, cyanate, exact, correct. So ammonium cyanate. So importance of organic chemistry, what is the importance of chemistry, organic chemistry? Ei byapar gulo jodi na jani tale hobe na. We should remember that the importance. Dekho, amra jodi kono ekta jinisher importance ta jani tahole shei somporke amader agroho bare, eto. So we should know the importance of organic compound. Why do organic compounds we should study? Why we should learn so many things from the organic chemistry? Because you know, in every field in our daily life we are using organic chemistry. So first one, pharmaceutical industries, that's mean oshudh patra, that's mean medicine. So most of the medicine prepared from the organic compound. Okay, most of the medicine prepared from the organic compounds. So this is the medicine. So medicine comes from pharmaceutical industries, which is comes from organic compound. Petroleum, you know about the petroleum, petrol, diesel, gasoline, kerosene, everything. Without this, we are unable to run. Okay, we are unable to run. Everything, everything will be stopped. If petroleum industry will be stopped, okay, then everything will be stopped. So LPG, gas. Without gas, we are not able to get any food in our home. Okay, so petroleum industry. So very important. ONGC, you know, ONGC. That's a most and powerful company in India, the highest paid company in India. Okay, this is ONGC. That's mean oil company. Clear? So LPG, kerosene, etc. It comes from petroleum industry. Now dye industry. In your room, you are sitting in your room and your wall is painted. Okay, so indigo, azo dye, etc. comes from the organic compound. Okay, indigo, azo dye, etc. Polymer industry, you know, every roofs or so many things, polyester, etc. are comes from nylon, nylon 66, terylon. তোমরা কি লিখছো কেউ? ছোটখাটো করে লিখে রাখতে পারো, হ্যাঁ, দরকার পড়লে আমি পরে এই ভিডিও গুলোকে আমি তোমাদেরকে প্রোভাইড করবো, ওকে? আমি আজকে যেমন একটা রেকর্ড করে রাখলাম, ঠিক আছে, এটা আমি রেকর্ড করে রাখছি। সো ডাই ইন্ডাস্ট্রি, ইন ডাই ইন্ডাস্ট্রি পলিমার ইন্ডাস্ট্রিজ, কারণ আমি যে যতগুলো লেকচার দেব, প্রচুর লেকচার দেব, ঠিক আছে, অর্থাৎ সেগুলো পুরো টুকতে পারবে কিনা আমি জানি না, আর যদি আমি নোটস দেবো পরে আবার ওই এক্সামের সময়গুলোতে ওইগুলো আবার কোশ্চেন আনসার করে দেবো, তাতে সুবিধা হবে, প্রবলেম নেই। আর এগুলো আমি মাঝে মাঝে ম্যাক্সিমাম টাইমে রেকর্ড করে রাখবো এরপর থেকে, ওকে? Next, plastic industries. We know plastic we are using daily in our daily life. Water bottle, everything plastic. Sure. Plastic bag. Okay. So plastic bags, bottles, everything comes from the plastic and it is organic compounds. Cosmetics, the ladies and girls who are using so many things, lipstick and snow powder, so many things they are using, okay, cream. So everything comes from the organic compounds, okay? So perfumes, creams, talcum powder, etc. Okay, so everything comes from the organic chemistry. So organic chemistry, the importance of organic chemistry is like this, and there are so many importance. There are so many importance. Food industries, you know, there is a cake, okay, or different color of cakes. There is so many creams, okay. Clear? So this comes from organic chemistry. The foods, okay, foods. If is food, every food comes from the organic compounds, okay. So everything. Carbohydrate, fats, proteins, sweetening and flavoring agents, all are organic compounds. Okay, all are organic compounds. Fertilizers industry. Without fertilizer, we will not able to get our foods. Okay, so fertilizers, that's in first was the urea, and there are so many fertilizers there from organic compounds. Okay, clear? So organic, the importance of organic compound is huge. There are so many importance. Textile industries, without textile industries we are unable to wear anything, okay? So from any position, okay, from any position we are not unable to get. Okay, without organic chemistry. So textile textile industry, nylon fiber like terephthalate, synthetic fiber, etc. All are coming from textile industry. Okay. Soap industry, now sanitizer industry. Okay. So everything comes from organic chemistry. Okay. Different types of soaps, detergents. Okay. Everything comes from organic chemistry. So importance of organic chemistry is high. Clear? So now, organic chemistry is the study of hydrocarbon and their derivatives. Hydrocarbon, hydrogen and carbon containing compound is known as hydrocarbon, like methane, hydrogen and carbon containing compound. So organic chemistry is the study of hydrocarbon, like methane, ethane. Carbon contains four hand, you know. Carbon always contains four hand. This is fully alkene and saturated alkene. That's mean carbon contains four hand and singly hand, or that single bonded carbon. When it is single bonded carbon, it is alkene. You know it. So organic compounds are numerous in number due to why carbon can form numerous compounds. A numerous number of compounds. Why? Because carbon has a unique property, which was the unique property, catenation property. The first one is high catenation property or ability. Second one is higher carbon-carbon bond dissociation energy. Carbon-carbon bond is high. So if they can form a bond and they are unable to dissociate easily, okay, so they are not easily dissociate. So high carbon-carbon dissociation energy and carbon-carbon tetravalency. That's mean carbon-carbon, there is a carbon-carbon tetravalency. Carbon can form four bond, okay, for this reason. Another compound exhibiting isomer. So many isomer can form, okay. So isomer, I will discuss about the isomer in the next year, I think. Okay, carbon exhibiting bonds multiplicity. That's mean carbon-carbon double bond, carbon-carbon triple bond, they can form. And there is hydrogen, or carbon-carbon triple bond, then carbon-carbon, again carbon. They can form so many bonds. And this triple bond is very, very stable bond. Okay, so carbon exhibiting bond multiplicity. Clear? And the ability of carbon atoms to form long chain or rings is known as catenation. Okay, so what is the catenation? Definition of the catenation is the ability of carbon atoms to form long chains or ring is known as catenation property. Is it okay? Any problem? Kono problem nei to? Agnik, Anik, Arkadiye, Arpan, Pratosh, Samarpan.
No sir, nahi problem nahi.
Kono problem nei to? Kono problem nei to?
Na sir.
Na sir.
Na sir.
Dekho, the element with highest catenation ability is carbon. Tale carbon keno, why carbon is most important and why they can form numerous number of compounds? Why carbon can form numerous number of organic compounds? This is the answer. Okay, because it has high catenation ability or tendency, higher carbon-carbon bond dissociation energy, carbon tetravalency or quadrivalency, compound exhibiting isomerism, carbon exhibiting bond multiplicity. Okay, the ability of the carbon atom to form four bonds is known as tetravalency. What is the tetravalency? Tetravalency is the ability of carbon atom to form four bonds is known as tetravalency. Is it okay? And to exhibit tetravalency, carbon forms all four single bonds. Yes, carbon forms all four single bonds, two double bonds, or one double bond, two single bonds, or one triple bond, one single bond, like this. we already see this triple bond and single bond. Carbon always contains four bond. Okay, so two double bonds, maybe they can form double bond. Okay, one double bond, two single bond. That's one double bond, two single bond, like this. Two single bond, one double bond. So there is a total four bond. In this way they can form bonds. Okay, ground state electronic configuration of the carbon. What will be the ground state electronic configuration? You know, carbon contains six proton or six electron. Yes, atomic number of carbon is six. Then electronic configuration will be 1s 2, 2s 2 and 2p 2. This is the outermost shell electronic configuration. This is the outermost shell electronic configuration. For this reason, they form four bond tetravalency. P orbital is 3, s orbital is only 1, 1 s orbital and 3 p orbital. S orbital contains 2 electron, p orbital contains 1, 1. If it is px orbital, if it is py orbital, this is pz orbital. Okay, and you know the magnetic quantum number also. Okay, now ground state electronic configuration is this, and in excited state this electron transferred to this orbital, this to this empty orbital, and this will be the electronic configuration in excited state. Clear? This is a 3p orbital, 1, 2, 3. So there is a one electron, 1, 1, 1. Now they can form or they can combine for octet rule. If there is a one electron, if there is a one electron accept, one electron accept here, one electron accept here, then total electron is 8. So they can form methane also like this. Okay, so in excited state electronic configuration of carbon is 1s2 2s1 2px1 2py1 2pz1. So they can form four bond in this way, four sharing bond. So for excitation, energy required for this, for this excitation, or for the excitation electronic configuration, some energy is required. Which amount of energy is required? 501.6 kilojoule per mole. For 1 mole carbon it required 501.6 kilojoule, though it is not important to remember it. Okay, now hydrocarbon and hybridization. Hydrocarbon and hybridization, what is the hybridization, what is the hybridization? And I will teach you about the hybridization. Hybrid, hybrid orbital. What is mean by this hybrid orbital? Since chandrima dekhbe ekhoni ektu pore kete jabe, ha ek minute pore kete jabe, abar on hobe, thik ache, ami abar link di debo, ha majhe majhe oi link e kaj hoy na, abar link debo. Okay, to jao, concept of hybridization, mixing of orbital. Mixing of orbital is known as hybrid orbital. Okay, tumra jano vedantika
yes sir.
Ha tumi na ki ajke na kalke jano ekta astu murgi khiyecho? Ha khiyecho? Eta ki shotti
na?
Shotti na
na
না শোনা গেল যে বেদান্তিকা একটা আস্ত মুরগি খাচ্ছে। তো তুমি কি ধরনের মুরগি খাও? খাও তো মুরগি নাকি?
হ্যাঁ স্যার।
কি ধরনের মুরগি খেতে ভালোবাসো?
ধরনের মানে?
হ্যাঁ, কি ধরনের মুরগি খেতে ভালোবাসো? দেশি মুরগি, বিদেশি মুরগি নাকি মুরগি নাকি বন মুরগি?
নরমাল নরমাল নরমাল
নরমাল বলতে কোনটা?
পোলট্রিটা।
পোলট্রি। ওকে, তাহলে তুমি দেশি মুরগি অতটা পাওনি আর কি। হ্যাঁ, দেশি মুরগি
টেস্ট পেয়েছি, ওর হাড়গুলো খুব শক্ত হয়। ও হ্যাঁ,
কিন্তু ওটা মাংস
ঠিকঠাক খেতে পারো? হ্যাঁ স্যার, দেশি মুরগির মাংস টেস্ট হেভি।
হ্যাঁ, ওটা টেস্ট একটু আলাদা। ঠিক আছে, তো আমি এই মুরগি নিয়ে একটু কথা বলবো আর কি। হ্যাঁ, তো এই ক্লাসটাতে আমি মানে এই জাস্ট কেটে গেলে আবার অন হওয়ার পরে আমি এই প্রসঙ্গে আসব। হ্যাঁ, তো মুরগি আমাদের খেতে হয়,
কেটে যাবে
মুরগি, আমরা পোলট্রি